Hi everyone, my name is Tracy and I'm here to give you a back pain yoga relief workout. So if you're feeling like doing a hardcore workout today, this isn't for you, all right? This is if you want to just chill out, relax, be calm, get a good stretch in, and also listen to some cool music in the background by DJ Dark. And I'm not monetized, so I'm just putting it out there. I'm gonna have some music, background music going. All right, so with that, let's get started. I want you to start off in easy pose, and that's Sukhasana. In easy pose, if your back is hurting you right now, take a blanket, fold it over like four times so you make a cushion out of your blanket. You can even use a stack of blankets if you like. Place the blankets under your pelvis and just sit right on top of the blankets. Take your ankles, cross them, and you're in Sukhasana. So with that, let's take a deep inhale, and I want you to just feel the entire spine lift and lengthen equal weight through each of your sits bones, each half of your pelvis equally weighted on your yoga mat or your blanket. Take a deep inhalation, arms reach into the air, and exhale. Good. Two more times. Just take a deep inhale. Create that awareness within your body. And then exhale through the mouth. Good. Energize your body from the inside out in a calm, peaceful way. Breathing in and then exhale. Excellent. Now from here, what I want you to do, emphasize the sides of your waistline, lengthening. All right, we want to create distance from your two hip bones away from your rib cage. Then I want you to take your left arm straight over your shoulder and gently bring it all the way down to the mat. Then I want you to take the right hand behind your head. Careful, avoid doing that. You don't want to push your head or neck forward. The neck is long. Elbow is straight to the side of your earlobe. Lift and lengthen up. Now I want you to inhale, and you're going to keep both of your sits bones on the mat and come all the way over. Maintain your pelvis touching the mat. I want you to stay here and breathe into the whole side line of your body. Breathing in and then exhale. Breathing in. Really feel ribs expand. Breathe into your belly. And then exhale. Getting all that old excess out of your system. And inhale. Open up that entire side. And then you're going to exhale. Good. Breathing in. Inhale, feel the air go deep down into your lungs. Exhale, draw your belly muscles back into the spinal wall. One more time, deep inhale. And deep exhale. Now slowly extend your arm in line over your shoulder. Start to lower your arm. Reach forward in front. And now on a diagonal, stretch both arms in front of you on a little diagonal. Maintain those sits bones on the mat under you and breathe in. Now I want you to think of the back of your pelvis broadening underneath you. Your low back is widening all the way across. Your sits bones are in contact with your mat. And really stretch your breastbone forward. I want you to lengthen your breastbone forward, your sternum, as the middle part of your spine stretches long in between your shoulder blades. Stay here and breathe. The top of the head is stretching far and away from your tailbone. Breathing in. Keep that spine reaching long. Exhale. breathing in and exhale. One more time, deep inhale and exhale. Excellent. Slowly bring your body upright. Reach both arms to sky. Elongate that central column of your spine. Really feel it stretch long. Inhale. And now exhale. You're going to take your right arm down to the floor by your side. Take the left hand, elbow in line with your ear. I want you to stretch. Press top of head to ceiling as that tailbone drops down into the earth, into your mat. Now, we're going to slowly start to stretch on this side of my body. I'm not reaching as far because I'm tighter. So if that happens to you, or if it already has, don't worry. Just pay attention to your bodily cues so you're not going to force anything. So allow your body to naturally go into the stretch and release on its own without forcing it. Breathing in. Allow those ribs to open apart. Breathing in, they cascade down and together. You want those six bones to remain on the mat. Inhaling through the nostrils. Bring that air down into the lower lobes of your lungs. Feel ribs expand. Breathe into your belly. And then exhale. Excellent. Breathe into the resistance, the tightness of your muscles. Breathe into them. And then just softly allow them to release. Breathing in, think how an artist has clay in their hands and forms the clay by gently molding it. So breathe, use the breath into your body to gently mold your muscles and allow them to open and release through time and patience. Inhaling through your nostrils and exhale through your mouth. Release that old energy, pent up. Welcome in the new energy, the new oxygen, the new prana from the universe, the newness. Exhale through your mouth. Keep lengthening. Inhaling. Exhaling. Notice how things tend to just gently release by themselves without you forcing. Breathing in. And exhaling. And one more time. Deep inhale. And exhale. Exhaling. Feel any resistance just slipping away. Gently extend your arm. Abdominals draw in. Slowly start to reach your arm forward in front of your body. And you're going to take the other arm right along next to it and slowly stretch out to the corner, to the right corner of your body. Slightly out in front of you on the floor. Breathing in. And exhale. As we stretch to the right, we're going to get the lower left quadrant of our back to release. Breathing in. Make sure that left sits bone is on the mat. You don't want to let it lift. Breathing in. Sink down into your pelvis. Navel stretches up away from the tailbone. Sink down into your pelvis. Stretch your breastbone forward, breathing in. And exhale. Excellent. Feel spine stretch long. Breastbone lengthens forward, breathing in. And then exhale. Gently release. One more deep inhale. Really stretch breastbone long, head away from tailbone, breathing in. And then exhale, softly release. Gently come all the way back in. Lengthen arms straight above you. And then exhale, just gently release down. Good. All right, this next exercise strengthens your low back. And if you feel tightness in the back of your upper thighs, your hamstrings, or tightness in your low back area, I still want you to sit up on a folded up blanket or folded up yoga blanket, whatever you have available. Sit on a pillow if you need to. It all helps. Lift your pelvis higher than your knees to help open the hips. So now, I want you to lengthen your legs in front of you on your mat. Legs stretch straight out in front of you. And actively, you're lifting the front of those thighs away from the kneecaps. Gently press down through the backs of those thighs. I want you to think of the backs of the thighs connecting downward into the mat. And then I want you to think of your thighs internally rotating a tiny bit in at the head of the femur bone. Pull together slightly. Press the back of those thighs into the mat. Elongate down through the legs. And you can stretch toes up. Flex your feet to get an active stretch all the way up the backs of your legs. So this one's called Dandasana Staff Pose. So we want a straight line, so your head, your ears are right over your shoulders, neck is long, shoulders are over your hips and your pelvis, and then you want to think of the front of the ribs and the back of the ribs meeting together, so it elongates that entire spine up. Then what I want you to do, your hands just gently are reaching down by your sides, and I want you to keep abdominals drawing into the spine, your two hip bones. Imagine those two hip bones coming closer together in front. Activate that deep abdominal muscle, transversus abdominis. And it's like you have a support system wrapping around you. Gently press your palms into the mat. And then I want you to feel width across the front of your shoulders and your chest. Gently press down into your palms and just breathe in. Exhale. I want you to stretch the top of your head to the sky. Just envision it, imagine it. Your top of your head is pressing upwards towards the ceiling or the sky. Your sit bones drop into the mat below you. And you're trying to stretch your spine in opposition. Oppositional energy, as above, so below, elongate. Abdominals draw in, breathing in, and then exhale. We want to feel width across your shoulders and your chest as you're sitting there. Reach through those heels, pull those toes back, breathing in. Sink down into your pelvis, into those sit bones. The back of the pelvis broadens, widens as that low back widens. Breathing in. Exhale. Feel your body energized from the breath. Bring that prana energy into the body, inhaling. Use the breath as a vehicle. Exhale, bring it to any tight spots in your body, your low back, the back of your legs, your hips, wherever you feel tight, breathing in. Exhale. Soften. Good. Ease into the stretch. One more. Breathing in. And then gently exhale. Feel how the bottom of the sit bones sink deeper into the mat. Good. Next exercise that I want you to do, we're going to do Paschimottanasana, which is a forward bend. And what I want you to do, actually, I like to make it a little easier on the body and then ease into the final form as we open and stretch. Fold your right leg all the way in. So seated forward bend. You're bringing the bottom of your foot along the inner thigh, groin of the opposite leg, and then you're just allowing that thigh to laterally rotate outward. So our hip joint is going to rotate, our femur bone rotates externally into the socket. We're going to stretch our adductor muscle, our pectineus, and we're getting part of our glutes to even stretch as we're sitting here like this. Now, your straight leg that's on the mat, it's actively working. I want you to think of that straight leg stretching long. And if you feel like your pelvis starts to tip backwards, it's important to get a blanket or a towel folded under your pelvis, under your sits bones or a pillow, to help your pelvis be in a more favorable alignment. We want to have a tiny little pelvic tilt. We don't want our pelvis tilt, okay. We don't want our pelvis to tilt posteriorly like this. I'm doing a posterior tilt right now. Because what it's doing, it's putting our spine in a compromising position. So we don't want that. Here I'm rocking my sits bones directly under me. My spine is now neutral. And I'm actually going to take my two hip bones and I'm going to shift my hip bones a tiny bit forward. Okay, when I shift my hip bones a little bit forward, it's going to help my spine stay in a more neutral position. So you could do this with your pelvis lifted a little bit. Now our leg is active. Think of your inner thigh pulling in a little bit. And then the front of the thigh lengthening away from the knee, elongate through your heel. So you're stretching through your heel. Equal pressure through each half of your pelvis. So for this forward fold, I want you to elongate the arms to the ceiling, really stretching high. Now we're going to reach from the crease here in our hip. I don't want you to reach from your waistline because that'll go into your back. We don't want to fold from our back. We're folding from our hip crease. Stretch all the way up, elongate up, lengthen your spine like a lever. Float forward, keep your spine nice and long. Now it's up to you. Your hands can come to the floor by your sides. You could stretch your arms forward more along the ground. You could even have a yoga block like under your elbows and rest your weight down on yoga blocks if you wanted. You're gently stretching forward. You can even grab a hold of your foot and slowly come forward even more. Breathing in. Deep breastbone lengthening forward, exhaling. That leg is active, abdominals draw in, ribs cascade forward, exhale. Inhale into the lower lobes of your lungs, feel ribs expand, breathe into your belly. And then exhale through your mouth. Just allow your body to release slowly with each breath, like you're kneading dough. And then exhale. Spine is long. Notice what sensations you feel in your body. Keep your spine lengthening, hinge from your hip, avoid bending at the waistline, hinge from the hip. Inhale, for a deeper stretch, flex your toes to sky. Create space in that low back area. And one more time, deep inhale. Deep exhale. Now we're going to take our arms, stretch straight to the ceiling. Extend the other leg out straight onto your mat. We're going to switch We're going to draw the other leg in. Bring the bottom of your foot towards your groin of the other leg, inner thigh or groin. Let your knee drop outward, external rotation of that hip socket. You're gently letting your thigh bones twist a little bit external, knee to sky. So the thigh bones twisting out externally. And then I want you to think of this one, gently allow your inner thigh to connect downward into the mat a little bit as you press the back of your thigh into the mat as well. And then just point your kneecap up, flex through your heel, reach through those toes, lift and lengthen. Now we're going to gently hinge from our hips, lengthen your spine. You can either have your elbows bent, resting on your forearms, resting on the mat like that. Keep your breastbone stretching long. You can have your feet, your foot flexed. You could reach towards your foot if you like. We're just trying not to round our back like this. We don't want to scrunch the chin down or round our back. We want to keep the neck long, space at the front of the neck, and hinge from the hip. Breathing in. Exhale. Think of aligning that center of the breastbone over your knee. Inhaling and exhaling. Breathing in. If you have the flexibility and want to rest your arms down on the ground, you can. Keep that spine reaching long. Breathing in. Exhale through the mouth. So you're aligning all your chakra points in your back. The tailbone drops and lengthens away from the breastbone. Top of head lengthens and stretches away from the breastbone. Our spine's lengthening in opposition. Those sit bones drop into the mat under your body. Breathing in. And exhale. Good. One more time. Breathing in. And exhale. Soften into that stretch. Gently reach arms to ceiling above you. Take that leg, extend it straight out on your mat. Really feel ribs lengthening apart here. So we're going to do both legs straight out, seated forward bend. We're going to stretch straight into the air. If your knees are tight or you have any knee issues, you can take a rolled up towel for support, place under your knees. Okay, stretch into the air. Hip hinge. Avoid reaching from your waist, reach from your hips all the way forward. On this one, I'm going to have you gently start your big toe bones pull inward, and I want you to think of rotating the pinky toes. Pull on the lateral edges of your feet and feel the connection of your inner thigh line. Inner parts of feet pull together, outside edges of feet you can pull against them. If this is too much of a stretch for you, you could place your palms up under the kneecaps as you hinge from your hip sockets forward like that, just to give a little support. You could reach towards your ankles too. And then you're gently stretching your breastbone forward, breathing in and exhale. Soften. Gently pressing backs of thighs into the mat, breathing in. Front of thighs are actively working. Exhaling. Breathing in. Bringing that oxygen into the body, into all your cells to nourish them. Exhaling all the old stagnant energy out of your body. Exhale through your mouth. Breathing in. Create space between ribs and hips so your low back has a chance to release and open. Inhale. And And exhale, Paschimottanasana. Exhaling. Breathing in. And exhale. Excellent. Let's hold for one more breath. And exhale. Gently make your way all the way to a seated position. Okay, since we folded forward, I want to have your spine release. And I'm going to have you go into a little bit of a child's rest pose, Balasana. And that way it's instead of like actively supporting your body, the way that we're on the ground and gravity pulls us down, you'll have more of an open feeling across the back without having to work so hard, because this is really strengthening your back on this one. So let's fold our knees in. If you need a cushion under the knees, you would put your blanket or towel under the knees. And then you're going to have your knees almost together. There's a little space there. Child's rest pose. So rest pose, child's pose, Balasana. On this one, I want to open you across your shoulders and chest to create some open space. So you're going to have your palms reach the sky, and you're just going to take your arms straight back down by your sides. So you're going to come all the way forward like this. You can have your head rest on a pillow, your forehead if you like. And then you're just going to let your arms rest down by your sides. Your arms rest down by your sides. Forehead is on a mat, a pillow, or a blanket. Whatever feels good to you. Again, this is just to help you have support and to open. Forehead on the mat. Take those arms. Actively reach your fingertips far and away from you and feel how it actually pulls. Instead of your shoulders being up here by your ears, actively stretch fingertips away, dropping the shoulders away from the ears. Actively stretch those fingertips. Your torso is just resting over your thighs. And breathe. Feel those shoulders open across the front. Breathing in. Exhaling. If this is comfortable for you, you can stay here. Stretch fingertips long. You could give yourself a little massage. Place your palms across the low back. And do small circular motion across your low back like this. Give yourself a little massage if you want to, if it feels good to your back. Tiny small motion massage. Palm does little circles. Inhaling and exhaling. You can continue like that or just have arms down by your sides. And exhale. Good. Two more deep inhales. And just enjoy the low back opening. Exhale. And one more time. Deep inhale. And exhale. Slowly take hands by sides. Press up. Gently bring head away from that. All right. We're going to come into table position on all fours. Your hands go under your shoulders. Your knees go under your hips. What I want you to do, we're going to do our bird dog to strengthen our back and to strengthen our abdominal muscles. Pull your core deep into your spine. Take your left leg straight back in line with your glute. Take your right arm in line with your shoulder. Straight line across those two hip bones. Hold here for 8. For 7, tighten your core. 6, and 5, and 4, and 3, and 2, and switch sides. Hold for 8, 7, 6, 7 and 6 and 5. Hips are stable, straight across. And 3, really stretch. And 2, last one, switch again. Now we're gonna pulse, tiny pulse. 8, 7, use your core. 6, 5, 4, and 3, and 2, last one, switch. 8 little pulses. 8, tighten core to spine. 7, 6, 5, and 4, and 3, and 2, last one. Plant palms right under your shoulders. Your knees are right under your hips. Let's go into cat-cow. So I want you to round tailbone down, chin towards breastbone, chin to chest, space between those shoulder blades, core scoops in to your spine. Now we're gonna inhale, stretch the top of your head away from your tailbone. And then you're gonna round that low back. Abdominal wall scoops in tight, tailbone drops. Spread those two blades wide to the sky. Breathe in and really elongate your entire spine. Exhale. Your breastbone lifts away from the mat, space and width between shoulder blades. Now stretch your tailbone to the wall behind you and look forward. 3 more. Exhale. Inhale, head away from tailbone. Exhale. 3. And 2. We want to really elongate your spine. Last one. Excellent. Okay, we're going to sit. I'm going to have you do Baddha Konasana. So we're going to stretch out our hips, because a lot of times tight hips contribute to back issues, because if we sit at a computer, guess what? Our hips get tight. I want you to think of your thigh bone rotating out. Rotate those thigh bones out, and then we're going to bring the side lateral edges of our feet to the floor, to our mat. And I want you to just allow your knees to naturally drop down to the mat. We don't want to force those knees down. We would just want to think of externally getting those hips, those thigh bones, rotate out. You can grab your feet. The lateral edges come together. Bound angle, this is called. So we're sitting up tall. Our sits bones are behind us. Our spine's